With experiential learning, where you learn a lot by doing, where you learn a lot by working, that you learn a lot of the skills that you need for other jobs, but that you also need to tackle these global problems and to make a contribution.
So my project focused on characterizing plant-associated microbial communities along an urbanization gradient from downtown Toronto to the Koffler Scientific Reserve all across the GTA. I collected samples of duckweed, brought them back to the lab for culturing and DNA extraction.
The Bees for Peace project works with faith communities, but also non-faith communities to protect our bees and our butterflies and our other creatures that bring us our fruits, our flowers, and our vegetables. They did a lot of research on native plants, and then they designed different gardens. They created maps of those gardens. They came up with a budget, they came up with a maintenance schedule, and everything that you need to know to do this yourself.
This was my first lab experience, so it was super valuable to learn some lab techniques and practices that I've never seen before. We were basically looking at microplastics around Toronto and the water. We were collecting samples in two main ways. We were using nets and pumps, so we collected the samples and then we had to filter them into jars for further analysis.
It was really insightful and it really got me to understand the whole research process all the way up to policy change.
A lot of the students already have some background in the natural sciences, and so now they have in their toolkit a whole host of communication strategies that they can use and a whole bunch of transferable skills that they can use in other venues.
I would definitely recommend the Research Opportunities Program to any student who wants a thorough and impactful introduction to research. One of the things that sets this program apart is the ownership and responsibility you get to have for a research project, as well as the time you get to spend with graduate students and professors learning from them.